Get set, go. The 2019 general elections are finally here and both BJP and Congress have come out with their manifestos. But whose manifesto says what? What do they say on jobs or national security, for example? Here's all you need to know. 1. On Kashmir. BJP has repeated its hard position on scrapping Article 370 that gives special status to Jammu and Kashmir and Article 35A about owning property in Kashmir, as they believe it is discriminatory against non-permanent residents and women of Jammu and Kashmir. They have promised yet again to ensure safe return of Kashmiri Pandits to the valley. In direct contrast, the Congress manifesto says Article 370 will not be touched. Congress also talks about reviewing AFSPA and ensuring free and fair assembly elections. It also expresses concern over repeated incidents of harassment of Kashmiri students across India. Apart from reviewing AFSPA, the Congress manifesto also plans to scrap the sedition law, that is Section 124A of the Indian Penal Code, and make defamation a civil offence. The BJP makes no mention of this in their manifesto. On Northeast, BJP has said again that they will enact the Citizenship Amendment Bill. They say they will clarify issues raised by some sections of population in the northeastern states. On the other hand, Congress wants to withdraw the Citizenship Amendment Bill. They also promise that no one will be left out of the final NRC. 3. On terrorism. Predictably, the BJP mentions the Uri and Balakot surgical strikes as examples of a never-before zero tolerance towards terrorism, promising a free-hand policy to the armed forces to deal with militants. Congress talks about focusing on internal security through intelligence, analysis, and quick response. They offer to set up a national counter-terrorism center within 3 months of coming to power. What about Ram Mandir? After lots of noise about the Ram Mandir late in 2018, the BJP seems to have taken a tactical call to reduce the rhetoric and play it safe, saying that they will explore all possibilities within the framework of the constitution to construct the Ram temple. 4. On farmers and poverty. Describing farmer distress and poverty as the big election issue, the Congress's mega manifesto promise is NYAY, the Nyuntam Aay Yojana, or the Minimum Income Support Program, targeting 5 crore families who make up 20% of India's poorest. They will be guaranteed an annual income of ₹72,000 a year. BJP, on the other hand, makes a more modest promise of ₹6,000 to all farmers annually, and also pension for small and marginal farmers who are over 60 years of age. On women's issues, both parties claim to be committed to 33% reservation for women in parliament and state assemblies, with the Congress promising to extend this to central government services as well. The BJP manifesto also says that the party will legislate a bill to prohibit and eliminate practices such as triple talaq and nikah halala. BJP links women's issues to its stand on the Uniform Civil Code, claiming there can't be gender equality till a Uniform Civil Code is adopted. 6. On healthcare. Congress has promised to enact the Right to Healthcare Act to provide healthcare services to every citizen. BJP, on the other hand, has made no new promises, but its manifesto mentions taking health and wellness centers to the next level by setting up 150,000 of these centers by 2022. On jobs, the Congress, claiming that unemployment has been one of BJP's big failures, promises to fill all 4 lakh central government and institutional vacancies by March 2020. It also says it will create 10 lakh Seva Mitra positions in every Gram Panchayat and urban local body. In the MNREGA scheme, Congress has offered to increase the guarantee days of employment from 100 to 150 days. The BJP manifesto plays down the issue of job loss, merely reminding the voter of its recent legislation of 10% reservation for the economically weaker sections of those from upper castes in government jobs and higher education. Clearly, both the manifestos are indicators of two different ideologies, with both documents espousing a different vision for India. Which India will the voter choose? We'll have to wait till 23rd May to find out.